is intentional. Never failing, I know that all things are working for my good. Yeah, he's intentional. Never failing, all things are working for my good.
Intentional.
Hey, and he's never failing.
Good morning, ladies. Good morning. Hey, everybody. Happy Monday. Happy Monday. Good morning. Yes, he is. All right, y'all saying it? Everything's working for your good? Yes. Intentional. It's such an awesome reminder, right? Such an awesome reminder. Everything is working for your good, even when it looks bad, right? Yes. Whoa. Oh. 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 The artist is Travis Green. Travis, my bad. Travis Green. I don't have to worry because it's working for me. Tell yourself, it's working for me.
I believe
it's working for me. Is it working for y'all? I don't have to worry.
It's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me.
Such an awesome reminder, right? I don't have to worry because it's working for me. Yes. Y'all, I'm singing this to myself this morning, right, Lakeisha? For real. I am so singing this to myself. I don't have to worry. It's working for me. Yes, it is. Good morning, y'all. I see y'all. Yes, he is. Yes, Sophie, tell him, girl. Yes. Hey, Marcia. Good morning. Absolutely, we will keep her lifted in prayer. We surely will. Yes, y'all. He's never failing.
Oh.
Oh. Isn't that an awesome thing? It is an awesome, awesome, awesome thing to know that everything that's working is working for us. That's like for real, for real. That's like big time. He's working that thing out, y'all. So you start thinking about all the stuff that's not right, and you realize that all those things, they're working for me. I might not know what they are called and those particular things are going to do, but what I do know is that everything is working for my good. And that's some good stuff, y'all. I'm just saying, that's some good stuff. It helped me. I don't know about y'all, but it helped me. And good morning, good morning, good morning. Happy Intentional Monday, ladies. Happy Intentional Monday. It is so awesome to have you all in the tribe this morning and that we are all standing in prayer one for another. I see all of us who are putting our prayer request on Periscope. So for those on Periscope, they know that they are able to put those prayer requests on there. And those of us who are there are standing in agreement with each of us as we are needing prayer for different things. Ladies on Facebook, if you have a prayer request, this is the perfect time for you to put it there so that your sisters and I can all stand in agreement with you. God said where there's two or three gathered in his name, guess what? He is there in the midst. And there's definitely well over two or three gathered between us and Periscope. We are absolutely more than two or three. And so I want you to know that you can always place those prayer requests listed in Facebook as well. I know we do it over on Periscope. We've been doing it for some time. When we have tests that are coming up, we're going through the process of learning something new. We're changing jobs. Our husbands are coming from literally getting out of jail and coming back home. When we have different circumstances, family members who are have gone to see the Lord, guess what? We stand in agreement one with another. And so we want to make sure that you all know that you are not just here to listen, but you are here to engage as well. And so we, as you are listening and as you are believing God, we can stand and believe and agree with you. So our scripture this morning, which is kind of interesting, I came up on 1 Samuel 3 and 9. And it's always an interesting journey. My life has been, over the last 3-4 years or so, actually probably since I've been married, has been a very interesting journey of walking out different things, which was interesting because I spent the first 30 years of my life very, very planned. I don't know about y'all, but I am a huge planner. I love to plan. I love, 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 love to plan. I love to know what's coming next. I love to be in the know of how to walk things out in a particular way and have the script and have the stuff before me that knows how to get there. And it was really interesting because I was able to do that because I was in the early stages of education. So yeah, we don't count the first 18 years, yeah. And then I decided to go off to college and I spent the next, 10 plus years in college doing different things. And so it was very easy to kind of plan out, to script out what that looked like. And so it's very planned. I want to do this. I want to do this. I want to get this together. I want to put these together. And so it was interesting how as I got past 30, I got married right after I turned 30. And I didn't have a plan. I kind of tried to put a plan together, but it was very different. And so I had to become a daughter of Christ that listened to follow instructions. And sometimes I don't want to just listen. I just want to know what it is that I need to do to get to the next step. And it's that is a proven record to get there, right? And so sometimes you just got to just be okay with just being in a place where you just got to listen and hear God's voice and walk it out. And so 1 Samuel 3 and 9 kind of hit me directly in my heart, just to understand, I'm asking God to speak because I am listening to what it is that I need to do next in my walk, this thing called life, right? And so is that overwhelmed by leaning towards God and his guidance and his strength? Yeah, it can be. And so there always are those things that are balanced things, but God is always speaking to us. He's always letting us know, like literally listening to He's Intentional this morning. God is speaking. There's so many ways he speaks to us. He speaks to us through his word. He speaks to us through psalms and hymns. He speaks to us through worship. There's so many ways that he's speaking, but are you listening? So if you woke up this morning, you got a heavy heart. You woke up this morning, you're like, dang, the rent is due. The mortgage is due. The gas bill is due. How am I going to pay it? Guess what? He's intentional. He is never failing. He will never fail you. And so it's always great to be reminded that God is listening. He is absolutely listening to what our needs are, and he's also absolutely speaking to answer that need, right? And so not only is God listening to our hearts, we have to listen to him. And so for those of you who have put your prayer requests in, we are standing in agreement with each and every one of you. I can guarantee you, as you are typing those prayer requests in right now, that someone is standing in agreement with you. I know I am. And so therefore, just know, God is speaking. He will give you exactly what it is that you need. So this morning, we are going to get intentional all week. All week, we want to be intentional about listening for God's voice to guide us, to lead us, and being confident in his voice, because his voice, sometimes he might say something that we don't necessarily want to do. He might give us instructions we might not necessarily want to follow at that particular time. But it doesn't mean that he's not speaking, right? It's not always, his voice is not always giving us a cheer. Go girl, go girl. Yeah. Sometimes it's a be quiet and be still. Sometimes it ain't for you to know. Sometimes it's walk it out. Sometimes it is just be quiet and allow me to handle it and let you know that he's intentional. And so it's just so awesome that we can be reminded of that. But we're going to be intentional this morning. We're going to be intentional this week about listening for God's voice so that we can be guided and directed in the areas and the places that we know if we can just do what he say do, right? Those areas and those places will be okay. Okay. So we are absolutely praying for Miss Bobby's family. I understand the hardship of our car accidents, right? I get it. All right, y'all, we are praying for each and every one of you. Let's get into our declaration. For those of you who are new, please, please, please give us a one so that we can welcome you. Welcome, welcome, welcome into our confession this morning. We're so thankful that you are taking some time out this morning to speak God's word over your life, over every circumstance and situation that you may be facing. And yes, some of our kids are going back to school today. So I understand that many parents are probably celebrating, but also making sure that they're covering their children in prayer, that they are well, that they are covered, that the blood of Jesus is over them. And we will continue to stand in agreement with you because of that. We know that this world system does have evil. This world system is full of evil. But guess what? So is this world full of our ability to speak God's word, to cover them with the blood of Jesus, and knowing that all shall be well in our homes, with our family, and as we go. Welcome all you awesome, wonderful ladies that are putting your ones in. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So glad to have you on. Katrina, good morning. Jennifer, so glad to have you on. All right, so since we do have some new timers, the way this works is that I'll give you the confession and you repeat after me. It's that simple. It's that easy. Ready? Yeah, let's do it. Let's make it happen. Repeat after me, ladies. In the name of Jesus, I declare I am in covenant with God. I declare that I have the peace of God. Therefore, I am whole, I am complete in every area of my life. I declare that there is nothing missing, there's nothing broken in my life. I declare I am empowered by God to succeed in everything I put my hands to do. Thank you, Lord, that my marriage, my job, my family, my business, my children, my finances, my health, and every relationship that I am connected to, I declare they prosper. Thank you, Lord. I too am prosperous and equipped to fulfill your perfect divine will for my life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, that today I hear your voice, I hear your instructions, and I follow them. Thank you, Father, that it is an intentional Monday. I am intentional. I am patient. I am calm. I am at ease in all my daily interactions. Today, I declare nothing shall by any means move me from my walk of patience, from my ability to listen and hear your voice, from my understanding of your guidance. Nothing shall move me from it. Thank you, Lord, that today your word, your very word, is a light unto my feet and a pathway to success in every area of my life. Thank you, Lord, that today stress, frustration, or fear, they're far from me, but I replace them with peace, joy, understanding, and love. I thank you, Lord, that today your word will continuously teach me, guide me, and lead me to truth, wisdom, and clarity of all actions, of all decisions I must make. Thank you, Father, that your word, your wisdom, will bring newness of life. I declare I have the ability and the capability to cast down all attacks on my peace, on my thoughts, on my awareness of your plans for my life. I cast them down in the name of Jesus. They cannot and will not steal your very voice, your joy, or your direction. I am able to hear your voice, and I will follow. I am able to understand your instructions, and I will follow. I am capable of walking out the very plans you have for my life, and I shall receive because I followed. Thank you, Lord, for peace, for patience. Thank you, Lord, for teaching me how to cooperate with your plans for my life. Thank you, Lord, for reassuring me that your plans for me are good and never evil. Thank you, Lord, for confirming in me I am on the right path, and that path leads to joy, success, peace, goodness. Thank you, Lord. I declare I am intentional. I am intentionally listening for your instructions, and I shall follow. I declare it is so. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, ladies, we are intentional. We will continue to walk it out. We will continue to stand knowing that you, Father God, are absolutely leading us and guiding us into all truth. Even when it's a difficult deal, y'all, difficulty doesn't mean God is not present. Difficulty doesn't mean God is not present. Difficulty just means we need to listen and follow and be in a place of peace, knowing that God is with us. It's just a reminder that he never leaves us nor forsakes us, right? It's just a reminder. And so we will absolutely be praying and standing in agreement with her, Adina. We have a sister in the wife tribe who is laying her husband to rest today, and we will be believing and standing in agreement with her that God's peace and that his comfort will be there with her, and that she will be able to stand even in the difficult, right? So we love you all. We pray for you. Each of you who have placed a prayer request in there, we see them, and we will stand in agreement with you, knowing that God is faithful to meet us exactly where we are, right? To meet us exactly where we are. Have an awesome intentional day. Y'all start listening for God's voice. Like, really, don't discredit his voice. Don't discredit. If he says turn left when you're driving, turn left. If he tells you, nope, don't go to that store, don't go. If he tells you to send something to someone, send it. If he says, send a text message, send it. If he's saying, do something, listen to his voice. It may seem small and minor today, but guess what? It shall be with a purpose. All right, ladies, we'll see you tomorrow. Have a blessed Monday. Be intentional. I love you all.